Welcome back. Let's play Starfield Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We just finished exploring this whole place. Took quite a while. I was supposed to be meeting... What's this person's name again? Oh, wow. Okay. Oh, by the way, we just updated version... 1.9.51.0, and it's like sluggish to respond sometimes. I don't know why. Speak to Delgado. Before we do that, what else is lying around here? And who else?
You see, you'll never crush the fleet. They'd have to catch us first.
Oh, yeah. About him.
A slow ship will get you caught. Talk to Jazz if you need upgrades.
I probably do. I still have the default stuff. Talk to Jazz, huh?
Yeah. I used to work for a megacorp. Wore a monkey suit and everything. Seems like a different time.
Hmm. Now you got this kind of suit. What kind of suit is that? You traded a monkey suit for another suit.
Near us are other new recruits.
You don't see me here. Recruit's gone. Oh, here's part four. Backpack stand? I'm gonna look at that in a second. Deck of cards. Like a door, kind of. Sort of. Something that was used to be a door and then covered over with metal plating. It looks funny. Suspicious. Alright, so... Which of these do we currently have? Okay, so we're still missing... one. And here's 2, 3, now we found 4, we need 5 and 6. I hate listening to them out of order, but...
Tell us about your arrest.
Oh, my arrest was spectacular. Definitely one for the record books. UC security sent an armada after our little fleet of ships and picked us off one by one until the remainder of us made it to the wheel.
For a listener's benefit, that was the star station in orbit around Voli that you destroyed just before your arrest, correct?
You see, that's what they'd have you believe, but the truth is much less sinister. There was a firefight on the wheel when they tried to bring us in. We holed up, but UC security unleashed hell. The damage they caused was catastrophic. We only surrendered so we wouldn't die when the station exploded.
Well, the UC says you set demolition charges to try and cover your tracks and make your escape.
That's their story. You'll have to go with your gut on what you think really happened. Anyway, they took us in and tossed us into the lock. That lovely resort they opened on Suvorov.
And you were imprisoned there for how long?
Well, it was supposed to be for life, Gale. But I ended up serving 2 years before I decided I'd had enough.
Is there any particular reason that you started the riots that eventually led to the worst prison break in United Colonies history?
Yes. I'm quite proud of that, actually. I honestly didn't think it would go as well as it did. As for the reason, well, it's simple. The UC were treating us like animals. The conditions in the lock were ridiculously bad, and no one cared. That's why they stuck us on that ice ball in the first place. Out of sight, out of mind.
Your escape caused the deaths of many that were stationed at the lock. Some would brand that as a bit dismissive for what you're describing as a protest. If you were simply advocating for your fellow inmates, why didn't you just go through the proper channels?
And what the hell was I supposed to do? Send a strongly worded letter to my duly appointed representative? Wake up. The UC only responds to actions, not words. In my mind, there was no other choice. You know what? Let's move past my time at the lock so we can get to the point of this goddamned interview.
Wow. Right with you guys. First things first, you know. I can take that, heart plus. Those are really handy. What's it again? Oh, thermos. That block is nothing, I guess. Command center. Mm-hmm. Like, wow, she sure takes her own good time, doesn't she? What about these other areas back here? Have I even been in them? What's in there? No. Interesting. Oh, locked. Only captain's room key. Oh. Have I been here then? But I didn't come that way, right? I didn't come this way. I came from here. Maybe these doors were closed before. Neva?
The fleet's the only family you need.
Well, that's your opinion. I want to play with all these instruments.
Got a few interesting leads for you. Check the mission boards.
Tell me what to do.
Rick?
Jerk? Cola? Ugh. Pure death. I wonder whose place this is. Kind of messy. Breadsticks, 177 and 252, and is a diary of Kiyosuke Nagata? I'm probably not saying that right. And I sit, like my grandfather and great-grandfather before me, I know I will never leave this prison. My wife said my family was cursed. The Nagatas thought perhaps whatever spirits we offended would leave us be when we fled Osaka, but maybe we are cursed. And all of this because I lifted baby formula. These laws are pitiless, leaving my wife, my child, with no hope. And I just sit here, getting angrier. They think they can just lock us away on some forgotten planet, but instead they feed this prison more bodies, more rage, more vengeance. One day the warden will pay. Maybe not this warden, but they will regret their justice, and our vengeance will be the stuff of legends. From the diary of Kiyosuke Nagata, an early prisoner in the lock who's eventually executed for staging a prison riot. Wow. Visit the Osaka landmark on Earth. What's the name of it? Oh, we still need to find more arrow. Tree branch. Okay, what? Is it an activity? Oh, it's just an activity, alright. Pick up a book and that happens. Oh, part six for the Crix interview. Second to last.
Tell us what the future holds for the Crimson Fleet.
Changes are coming, Gale. Huge changes. Crimson Fleet will soon be a much bigger player in this little game between the members of the settled systems.
That's quite a bold statement. Would you care to elaborate?
Well, let's just say that I'm on the brink of a score so large, it makes everything else pale in comparison. Beyond that, the others have to wait and see.
If you aren't willing to discuss the details, why grant SSNN this interview?
Simple. I refuse to allow the UC to spin or bury the story, making it sound like they're in complete control of the situation. I'm gonna tell you right now, they aren't.
Why does the Crimson Fleet need to make this mysterious move that you're being so evasive about?
I know Sysdef instructed you to draw this meeting out as long as possible. So let me sum this up.
So they can get him?
I intend to make sure that the Crimson Fleet becomes the United Colony's worst nightmare. And nothing, I mean nothing in this universe, will stop me from achieving that goal.
There are those that would disagree with you and claim this interview is grandstanding, or worse, a recruitment tool. After all, SSNN reaches every corner of the settled systems, and your aspirations could inspire the directionless to turn to the fleet.
You and the sheep that listen to your garbage can believe whatever the hell you want. If you were so worried about what I had to say, you wouldn't have allowed yourself to be brought here.
Wow. So, what are we missing? Just five now, I think? Oh, one also. Yeah, one and five. They have not been in order. Are you perusing the artwork here? Well, what do you have to say for yourself? Okay, you're getting creepy on me now. Too creepy for me. Notebooks. Oh my god. Now you're super, super creepy. That was like a semi jump scare for me. Intercom? Your intercom's broken. Got a tiny little fridge. Your care works wonders. Why do they have this thing in here? Give quality support your local... Give quality to support your local United Colonies branch. I might have read this before. Yeah, I read that in New Atlantis. Are you sure? Yeah, I know. I'm saving, like, for absolute last.
I heard Isla's sister is some hardcore mercenary. I wouldn't get on her backside.
This job is gonna rake in a ton of creds.
A ton of creds. Alright.
Better get a move on before Dale sees you slacking.
I want him to see me slacking. Talk to everybody.
So,
him. Hey, no.
Now that we are all here, it's time to get down to business.
Let's try to talk to her.
The two of you are the only rooks that have made the latest cut. The rest, well, let's just say they won't be joining us ever again. Neighbor's willing to put her neck on the line and vouch for you, which means you've got what it takes to join the Crimson Fleet.
I will not disappoint.
You'd better not disappoint, or you'll find yourself answering to me personally.
I just said I will not
disappoint. All
right, point.
Let's get started here. When you sign up with the Crimson Fleet, you're in it for the long haul. No one quits. No one retires. The only way out is death.
You
stay loyal or you pay the consequences. Fleet before friends. Fleet before family. Fleet before yourself.
I can't agree with that one. Not me, myself. I don't like. I hope that doesn't include fleet before breakfast, because I like sleep late.
Hey, if you've got a problem, I can decorate that wall behind you with your brains.
Oh my god.
Room could use a little color if you ask me.
No, just let me sleep late.
It's all right, neighbor. I admire this rook's backbone. Takes a lot of guts to crack jokes with the threat of death staring them in the face.
Can we get on with this? I want to get drunk at the Last Nova.
Oh.
I'm impressed.
That's a female.
That is the first intelligent thing you have said this entire time, Mathis.
He hasn't said anything.
Since you two seem so eager to move forward, let's get to your next job. Pack your cold weather gear, rooks. Where we are going, you're going to need it.
Oh, God, don't tell me you're dragging him down to Suvarol for another one of your little initiation runs. 10 Johns to the surface, 12 dead rooks. You'd think by now you would have given up on that goddamn campfire story.
Crix's legacy is no story, neighbor. We've got fresh eyes in the fleet. And if these two want to impress, they're going to help me search those ruins.
Ruins,
I hope you're right, Dale. That new code we grabbed for the lot cost us a ton of credits. And a decent captain.
This initiation, as Neva calls it, is your chance to see where it all began. On Suvorov. With Jasper Crix. Crix led the riots that gave birth to the Crimson Fleet. And if his legacy is still out there, we're going to be the ones to find it.
Okay. Well, I'm really worried about where I'm going to find those interviews. Episode 1 and 5. I need to complete the set. So you take every new pirate on these initiations?
Of course. Where else could I find such a perfect location to weed out any rooks who'd be wasting the fleet's time?
I don't know. The surface of the sun? How many tests and initiations do I have to go through? Let me guess. As many as you feel like putting me through, or I can die.
What? Were you expecting a goddamn graduation ceremony? Think I'm just going to slap a skull on you and send you on your way? Make no mistake. You are being tested all the time. Every job you take will be under constant scrutiny. That's and nice. Neighbor? Oh, she's just waiting for you to screw things up.
Technically, I already did, just on purpose. What's this code that Nave is talking about?
Through a bit of luck and a hell of a lot of cash, Nave was able to get her hands on an access code to the inside of the lock.
Is that a prison?
This will be the first time someone from the Crimson Fleet has set foot in there for, well, since Crix left the place behind. It has been frustrating being this close to potential clues, but not being able to find a way through those prison walls.
Hmm. Maybe you should tell me more about Crix's legacy.
Before Crix left the fleet, he left a message talking about a major score. One that would set up the fleet to be a big player in the settled systems. Somewhere down the line, they started calling it Crix's legacy. And everyone who's tried to find it has wound up empty-handed, missing, or dead. If we're gonna beat those odds, we'll first need a lead. And I would wager we will find one on Subaroff.
Dale's leaving out the best part. That this whole search is based on a handful of words on a very old slate.
Oh, really?
Crix left a lot of big talk on that recording, and not a lot of facts. Some of us believe in it more than others.
Don't listen to her. When we get our hands on Crix's legacy, the fleet will be operating at a completely different level. We will become more than a match for UC Sysdef.
Oh. What is his legacy? What if Nave is right and Crix's legacy isn't real?
Listen to the words that I am saying. The legacy is real.
What if I listen to
you
words she's saying?
You'll find that out in due time, provided you're willing to put in the work. Nothing worth having ever comes easy.
Though the idea of the legacy has probably been blown a bit out of proportion, I'm certain there's an element of truth to its existence.
Hmm. Okay. Well, won't the fleet just become a larger target for Sysdef then?
You forget the UC is still licking its wounds from the colony wars. They don't have the capability to mount a full-scale assault. And if they were foolish enough to attack, we would have the manpower to push those pendejos right back to Jemison. If we have Crix's legacy.
Okay. Well, let's just get on with it then.
Sounds like someone wants to get down to business.
Why not?
Okay, enough discussion. We have got a lot of work to do.
Mm-hmm.
To that end, the next stop is the lock. I've had Jazz feed the coordinates into your ship's computer.
Oh.
Since Mathis doesn't have a ship, he's going to ride with me. I'll see you down there, Rook. Don't keep me waiting.
Pirate swashbuckler gear. Has been added. Echoes of the Past. Is there anything you can tell me about Jasper Crix's history before he ended up in the lock?
I could tell you stories that would last for hours. But now is not the time. You have a job to do, and I don't like to be kept waiting. When you... Well, if you get back to the Key, I am sure you can find some copies of the interview he gave to SSNN around here somewhere. Yeah. I think those recordings might give you the history lesson that you are looking for.
Missing two of them. You mind if I ask more about this initiation?
Yeah, what is it?
Mathis, who is this guy? What's the deal with Mathis?
There is no deal. You and Mathis are two sides of the same coin. A couple of rooks fighting for a spot in the fleet. Only problem is that he is down a ship and you are not, which puts you ahead. Just barely. Who knows? Maybe he'll get lucky and you won't make it off Suvorov in one piece.
So they're not even counting my friend here. I thought she was joining also with me. What can you tell me about Suvorov?
It's cold. Bitter cold. Just about the last place you would want to find yourself without heat. The few living things that can survive the extreme temperatures are constantly fighting to stay at the top of the food chain. The Crimson Fleet called Suvorov the White Hell. To me, it's paradise. Someone up here pisses me off enough, I send them down to the surface for a little overnight visit. Snaps them right back into line.
Okay. Can you tell me more about the lock?
The UC built the lock as a supermax prison a little under... Well, it must have been at least 100 years ago. Before that, those Concha Jesus Madres marooned prisoners on the planet's surface and left them to their own devices. As you can imagine, these turned into some kind of demented survival of the fittest. Prisoners killing each other for a chance at meager supplies. Luckily, some whistleblowers back in New Atlantis saw this as cruel and unusual punishment and pressured the UC into building the facility. 5 years after the prison was completed, Cricks touched off the riots that overran the lock and eventually the key.
Uh-huh. What happened to Jasper Cricks there?
Nobody knows exactly what went down. I mean, there's all sorts of rumors. Cricks was in prison for almost 5 years, and judging from the look of the facility, every moment must have been miserable.
He said
I suppose he just got fed up and decided to take matters into his own hands. Got the prisoners behind them and kept pushing until he reached the key. The cojones on that guy. UC's toughest supermax prison, and he just waltzed the hell out of there like it was nothing. I would love to have been a part of that.
Yeah, he said 2 years. He was sentenced for life. All right, that's all for now, peasant.
Fine, and get moving.
Well, what'd that box ever do to you? This place just emptied out. Oh, is there still that one there? Who is this other guy? Oh, is that you?
Don't you have business on Suvorov?
Hi.
I thought Delgado needed you on the planet. Why are you talking to me?
You tell me anything about Mathis.
Mathis is a real piece of work. Adler shoveled him onto us about a week before you turned up. One of the greediest rooks I've seen come through the key in a long time. Dumb as a bag of spanners, too.
Wow.
Do you know he had the guts to ask Delgado for jump fuel compensation after being asked to fly out here? He didn't get it, but damn. If you want my advice, save everyone the trouble and make sure he doesn't come back from your little planetary excursion on Suvorov.
Oh, wow. They want us to kill him? Or she wants me to kill him? Am I right in assuming you don't believe Crix's legacy is real?
Let's put it this way. I know Delgado needs something to give rooks like you some confidence. But let's get real for a second. Do you really think Crix could hide that much wealth and keep it hidden from the rest of us for over 100 years? No way. Secrets last as long as supernovas around here. No one can keep their mouth shut unless someone shuts it for them. Nah. It's all a bunch of bullshit. Look, I'm not trying to bust Dale's balls. He's not the first to go looking for that fairy tale, and I'm damn sure he's not gonna be the last.
He can probably hear you. Just asking this would make someone trust me less? I mean, if... possible. And this is a stupid question because I'm a rook.
Good luck.
I'm looking for Mathis.
Were my instructions unclear? What do you want?
I want to kill you. Alright, so. And yes, your instructions are very unclear. Shot glasses. I wonder where those. Like. I don't know if I missed them, or those other two just aren't around, those two interviews. I probably missed them. Alright, so... Delgado has asked me to meet him on a planet called Suvorov, the supposed origin of Crix's legacy, together with exploring in Supermax prison called the Lock in an effort to uncover information about the elusive treasure. Okay. We'll do that. Oh, you're Mathis.
It's cold as hell on Suvorov.
I don't know about you, but I think the welcome sign really lends itself to the alluring charm of this star station.
Oh, this? Yeah. So... they give me pirate swashbuckler gear. Docking bay. I've never been in docking bay. Or maybe I have. This is like where I first came in, I think.
I don't trust shielding. I got secret compartments on my ship just in case.
Part one. Maybe the other guy who was sitting here before was sitting on it. Part one.
Hello, everyone. I'm Gail Dunnigan of SSNN, and this is Galactalk. My guest tonight is one of the most notorious criminals in the settled systems. His ruthlessness and desire for wealth has landed him squarely at the top of the wanted list for every major law enforcement agency in the galaxy. I am, of course, speaking of the self-appointed leader of the Crimson Fleet himself, Jasper Crix. Good evening, Mr. Crix.
Good evening, Gail. Thank you for accepting my invitation.
Yes, well, being blindfolded and then grav-jumped to what appears to be an abandoned mining facility isn't exactly what I call an invitation.
Well, I'm sure you're not surprised that your request for an interview would come with some very specific conditions.
Frankly, I was a bit surprised to receive any type of response at all. Would you mind telling me why you decided to do this interview?
Because there comes a time in every pirate's life where they have to make an extremely important decision. Do they take a leap and become one of the most legendary pirates in history? Or do they simply sputter on, subsisting on freighters and deep space privateers?
So are we to assume that you are taking the leap? That Jasper Crix is moving on to bigger and better things in his life?
That's spot on, Gail. That's exactly why you're here.
Interesting. Well then, would you mind sharing with us exactly what your particular leap entails?
In due time. There's no rush. In fact, I'd say we have at least 12 hours before the authorities trace this broadcast. Plenty of time to discuss whatever you like.
Oh, all right then. Perhaps the best place to start this interview would be at the beginning of your career.
Please, proceed.
Funny. And then in the second to last one, in 6, he accuses her, well, somewhat passingly accuses her, of stalling. So, you need to tell me it's been almost 12 hours for this whole interview? Well, I wish I knew what the other one was.
The fleet is family.
Yeah.
Stealing from each other is just what you call a professional courtesy.
Stealing is a professional courtesy. The family that steals together stays together? That's some stuff around here. I've been here. This is where I put that... that's my friend Wilby. That's where I put the Aurora. Yep. So I found it and put it back.
Smuggling beats a real job any day.
Okay, then. Alright. Finally back at our ship. I'm gonna call it an episode here. Actually, what I'm gonna... if I find... well... I want to play them all in order, but I want to find... the one I'm missing. I'll search off screen.
What are you looking at?
A jerk? I was gonna say another word. Oh, there's a fragmentation mine. For free. Maybe I should do it off screen. Find this last one. Just think, it could be anywhere. And then I want to play them all in a row. I was gonna do it at the end of this.
Are you looking to start something? Cause I'll finish.
You ain't finishing crap. That's me. Yeah, stand by, guys. I'll be right back. Okay. I don't think I've talked to her.
If you want to stay under the radar, I've got just the thing.
It's Jasmine with ship services.
So, looks like we got ourselves a new rook.